Hello, beautiful souls, and welcome. Welcome to the channel again. For those of you who are returning subscribers, today we're doing a career pick a card. What is coming up for you? What opportunities, what decisions do you have to make in the next 3 to 4 months? But especially in the month of June. Obviously, I'm always loose with the time frame. I just use it as a guideline. If anything else beyond that time frame wants to show up in the cards, I will obviously tell you. So yeah, that's pretty much it. It's gonna be a career update reading, and I hope you're interested in this type of reading. I haven't done one in sort of a long time. So we have three piles or three groups, and you'll be choosing one of these pictures. This is one collage that I made a while ago. So this is pile number one with the sun in the center. You have forests, you have trees. It's very DIY, as you can see. I don't even remember why I made this, but I was just having fun. So this is for pile one. If you resonate with this image, then this is probably going to be your pile. Pile two, you are another abstract, weird collage of mine. This is paint, acrylic paint that has dried out, and I used it to compile this card, whatever this is, this is supposed to be. So yeah, pile two, if you resonate with the colors, with the aesthetic, I guess, of this little collage, this is gonna be your pile. Pile two. And pile three, this is a postcard from a friend of mine, from Petra actually. So if you resonate with this place, it's a sacred site, or if you simply resonate with the image, then pile three is gonna bring your messages. Alright, I hope all the images were clear when I put them up close to the camera. You can pause the video, take a look at the messages, meditate on them, and see which one resonates the most. And the timestamps will be in the description box as well as the comment section. And let's get started. So let me put these aside. I have a pretty free-flowing idea for how I want to do this reading. I'll be just pulling cards as if I was doing a reading for a friend. I really love these types of readings because they're very natural, and yeah, it really feels like I'm talking to a friend. So pile one, let's see what career opportunities do you guys have in the next 4 months, especially in the month of June, but the next 4 months. Okay, so you've been working hard. I saw the Ten of Wands flip. So let's see. What opportunities do you guys have? Pile one. Okay, I'm already getting some messages. There is a card that flipped upright, but I'm going to check it after I say my message. I already start to hear music, and I'm hearing concerts, celebration. So some of you might be working in the industry of organizing events, and I see some quite big events. I see celebration, and I'm hearing lots of different musical instruments. Somehow this might be related to your career, or you might be celebrating with your colleagues, and you might have a trip that you all go to. Yeah, I'm hearing Virgos, especially Virgos watching this will resonate with you, but also Virgo energy. Virgos are all about working hard and playing hard. Although they're supposed to be the holistic sign, they're actually quite extreme. Yeah, you have the Page of Wands. There is a reason to celebrate something. The Page of Wands talks about new, fresh ideas, inspiration, and new opportunities that are almost like blessings, God-given gifts. You didn't expect them necessarily, but you're very enthusiastic, very excited about it. So I do see that in your career, in the next 4 months, exciting things are coming up. Creative freedom is coming up. Perhaps after having a crisis about your own creativity and doubting it and questioning it, or wondering, am I even going to make it in this industry? Finally, your sense of style starts to make sense to you, especially for those of you who are in the creative world. If you're an artist, your style, your aesthetic matters a lot when it comes to making money off of your art. And I feel that for some of you who questioned how good you are, are you going to resonate with a certain audience? I feel like your identity is slowly coming together, and there is a little fly over here that is accompanying us during the reading. Okay, so what's coming up in the next 4 months in your career pile one? Four of Swords. You're surrendering something. I feel like you guys are surrendering to time. Perhaps your identity, your brand coming together and getting recognition, it needs to take some time before you reach that level you desire. So with the Four of Wands, you're surrendering your control, your desire to control the situation, because you really cannot. You have to just put your work out there or commit to your ideas, commit to your vision. However, the rest is really up to the universe. You do the grind, you do the work, which I saw the Ten of Wands wanted to show their face when I was shuffling for the very first moment in the reading. And I think that this is very much an indication that you've worked really hard. And now you should release control. You've done the work. Just commit to the vision, really. Commit to that, I want to say, a creative snowball effect. Like, the more you create, the more you figure things out, the more you explore your talents and skills, and the more you train, the more your sense of identity and sense of style, once again, in which you complete your work, in which you execute your work, will come together. But the Four of Wands show me that you do need some rest, you do need some meditation to bring your focus back to center. Sometimes too much enthusiasm can scatter us, and we get lost, and we lose a sense of orientation, and our goals become a little foggy. Our vision becomes a little unclear. We get committed to way too many things because we were so excited all of a sudden. So I do see your excitement dying down a little bit, but not in a negative way. You're just trying to, okay, this is a really cool thing, but now let me chill and let me sit still with it and reflect upon it. Definitely with the Four of Swords, reflection is required, surrendering is required, focus and rest of mind is required. Don't tire yourself out. Don't burn yourself out mentally by envisioning 10,000 things. Do things methodically, one after the other. I think that's why I heard Virgo energy, because I think with you guys, you have a lot of ideas, and it's very tempting to try to do them all at once. But Virgo is very methodical. So one task at a time is the best approach here. What career opportunities are coming up for pile one in the month of June and the next 4 months? The World and Ten of Cups. Beautiful. It looks like you are finding your audience. For those of you who are entrepreneurs, for those of you who are not hired, what's the word? You work for yourselves, self-employed. For those of you who are self-employed, with the World and Ten of Cups, it seems that you're finding your people, you're finding your clientele, you're finding your audience, and it seems that you will have many happy clients. The Four of Swords could be talking about sleeping on your potential a little bit as well. So it's not just the rest. We're going to clarify the Four of Swords in a minute. But yeah, it is possible that some of you are getting ideas that are cool, and you might think, or one particular idea that is really cool, and you're sleeping on it. But with the World card and the 10 of Cups, this is, you have completion twice. Number 10 is completion. The World talks about completion. The World also talks about something coming into existence, something coming into fruition, because the World card is that gate of passage from the spiritual. So the whole journey in tarot begins with the Fool and with the Magician, etc. And that spiritual journey in the spiritual realm ends in within the World card, and after the World card, within the Minor Arcana, you enter the physical world. So that's why this is a gate, this is a portal for materialization. We have Saturn being present, ruling this card, and with the 10 of Cups, I think you're either gathering people together, if you are indeed organizing events as I had a vision of, you're finally gathering people together, you're having a reunion with clients you've worked with for a long time, you've waited for this. It could be a retreat with the Four of Swords, by the way. It could be a retreat that you've planned for a long time and you've been very excited for a long time. For others, you're simply finding the right clients, or you're surprised with an influx of clients after a long period of people sleeping on you, or your business not really budging much financially. Perhaps you were doing all the marketing, but the finances were not really working out as you expected or hoped that they would. And now they finally are. Your finances are finally picking up. And this has to do with good relationships, like really good, generous, hearty relationships with your clients. Okay, now let's clarify the underlying energies for your career. The Three of Pentacles. A lot of you have been waiting to release an idea or a skill or a service that you've been learning for a long time. Maybe you went to school for this and you're finally making money out of it. This is something that you've been practicing and practicing and practicing. You've been working hard, I'm telling you. This is something you've definitely practiced, but finally you're hopeful and enthusiastic that it could reap results. So it almost feels like some of you believed that your skills and knowledge will end up being useless, because how am I going to turn this into a business? How am I going to offer this as a service? Am I ever going to be good enough to sell this? And finally, I think you're coming out with a product. But with the Page of Wands, there is this childlike play and courage that needs to. You need to listen to that. You need to listen to this courageous drive that awakens within you. Two of Wands. Oh, wow. Some of you had to surrender an opportunity to travel in order to commit to your plans, in order to commit to your own business. And I think, especially for those of you who are trying to secure an apartment, a home, it could be with a partner or alone, it doesn't really matter. The Ten of Cups is the happy family, but I like to think of it also as a happy home. For those of you who've been trying to secure an apartment, or a stable, secure living situation, you had to cancel plans that required you to be elsewhere, perhaps even invested in other people's work. Maybe you finally gave up the job where you worked for someone else in order to stand your ground and grind for your own ideas in your own business. I'm getting you surrendered something that was very alluring, you surrendered something that was very tempting, and I think that's why Saturn is coming here with a blessing with the World. The World is followed by the Ten of Cups, which tells me Saturn comes with this blessing. Saturn is congratulating you on a tough decision that you had to make. You had to sacrifice pleasure, or you had to sacrifice quick money. You had to sacrifice something that was calling you, because the Two of Wands is we are charting the world, trying to conquer it. We're planning ahead, planning the future, and the future is, I mean, depending on how you see it, obviously, but very often when we plan for the future is so alluring. We don't want to be in the present moment. So perhaps you were seeing an opportunity that this could pay off in the future, etc., etc. However, you woke up to the fact that at some point you have to commit to you, not other people, not other people's territories. King of Swords. Yeah, you, oh my god, you made the right decision, exactly. The King of Swords indicates a period in your life when your mind is very lucrative, very productive, and your concentration brings results. Okay, that is the King of Swords. All the kings are masters of their elements. They are masters of their domains. So when you have the King of Swords, you are a master of the air domain. You are becoming a master of communication, marketing, gathering the necessary information in order to up-level yourself, your skills, your business. So this is really great. Great networking, great communication, access to really useful information as well. Having this, what's the word, a hunch? I think that's the word. Having this instinct for where to insert yourself, where to research, who to talk to. The King of Swords emphasizes these qualities within you. It strengthens these qualities within you. And the Two of Pentacles. A gambling situation about a home, about purchasing a house. I do see influx of money in your life from really good, generous clients and clients that really appreciate you. But at the same time, with the Two of Pentacles, you still don't know where you stand. Maybe when it comes to investing in land, maybe when it comes to even a relationship, and somehow your career is dictating the flow of this relationship. You could be dealing with an air sign, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. You could be dealing with a Virgo, Capricorn. For me, the Two of Pentacles is something about changing your contract, either switching to a new contract, canceling a contract. This is the constant withdrawals and inputs of money. So you could really be investing. You're withdrawing from one account and putting money into another. You have to organize your finances a little bit better. Don't put everything in one place. You have to organize your spendings. You have to become a bit more diligent with your money. Like, have an account or a card that you pay with that's your monthly, I don't know, spendings on groceries and just whatever other daily stuff you need money for, and have another account for your bills at the end of the month. Have an account for investing. there's something about having different cards or financial accounts, and you play with your money or you use your money strategically. It's almost as if everything is in one place. It feels like, oh, I have a lot, now I can spend a lot. So it's important to put things in different places. I'm hearing remaining realistic about your financial situation. Do not allow your enthusiasm and inspiration to actually spoil things for you. Enthusiasm and inspiration, they're great to experience, but don't let them spoil the stability. We have the air element yet again, open-mindedness, objectivity and learning. Yeah, definitely master of the air element. Libra, an air sign. Fairness, harmony, consideration. And Neptune, dreams and transcendence. Okay. Neptune talks about institutions, especially the forgotten ones. Libra's contracts. There's something nebulous around certain offerings that you receive or you will receive. So I do see a nebulous opportunity. I do see the opportunity to sign up a contract to work for someone. It looks like a big company with a history, because it feels like one big family, and Saturn is all about the big structures, the corporate structures. So it looks like you are offered a job somewhere big. But with Neptune, the thing is with Neptune, Neptune talks about your dreams, of course, but Neptune primarily talks about loss and sacrifice. Should you accept this corporate job? Is this like for everyone, or is this a specific message for some people here? Because in the beginning, I was really seeing how you were deciding to work for yourselves. Of course, understand that not every field allows that, and not everyone dreams to work for themselves. Five of Pentacles. Should you accept this contract? Wait, wow. Knight of Swords, it's a rushed decision. Funny, you have the Knight of Swords and the Knight of Pentacles. Rushing or slowing down? It will depend. That's what I'm telling you. You have to take care of your finances and be more diligent with it, because whether or not you should take this contract depends on, are you desperate for money? Are you in a rush to pay off debt to, you know, improve your situation? Or can you slow down? Do you have enough savings to afford trusting in your own destiny and not kind of selling yourself to someone else? Because I don't like Neptune here. Neptune talks about secrets, so this contract will hold secrets. It will be based on emotions and persuasion and charm and idealism, but it's not going to be based in reality. Clarify the Two of Pentacles, Spirit. Queen of Wands. Clarify the Two of Pentacles. I think you should not sell off your independence, especially your financial independence. So purchasing something along with someone else may not be the best idea because I do see you tearing the property apart. If you purchase a home, an apartment with someone else, like you split it, I do see a split later in the relationship. Be very careful who you collaborate with, who you build a business with, because especially if you notice little signs that you have a different vision, you have a different idea for the future, don't do it just because, well, currently we're on the same page, but I could totally see us drift apart later on. Don't do it if you can see each other drift apart. Yeah, so committing to yourself, committing to your own vision, and sacrificing the quick success is gonna be worth it. You're gonna be blessed with clients. You have to trust in that. I see clients for those of you who are self-employed. For those of you who are waiting on someone and your future depends on someone, or your future depends on, getting an offer, signing up a new contract. I just want to tell you that this new contract, you have a lot of Neptunian, Piscean energy. This new contract is very, very nebulous, and it's not really sure if it's going to work out or not. So keep that in mind. You read the small text, read the fine text, read everything on the damn paper. Because sure, Neptune can talk about your dreams and ideals are coming true, but with the Two of Pentacles and underneath, I'm getting scheming situations, I'm getting disbalance, so yeah. All right, pile one. This was a short and sweet reading, but this is what I felt like doing, so I'm not gonna dive into more details. I hope this resonated for those of you who had some messages to hear. Let me know in the comment section below, and as always, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to support my work. And you can find all of my information in the description box below. Until next time, bye. Okay, pile two, welcome. Welcome to your reading. Let me sit with your energy for a little bit. Interesting, I glanced at this card, and for some reason, in the silhouette, I saw Batman, so for some of you, bats could be significant, or you could have, I don't know, you could be watching Batman, maybe you watched it recently. I don't know, I just saw it. So somehow it's gonna be significant. Okay, let's see. What's coming up for you? Coming up in your career, file two. I'm getting a lot of Piscean energy, connected to healing. So a lot of you are healing perhaps after you lost. Maybe you lost money, maybe you lost your job. A lot of you are rehabilitating basically after a great loss in your career. Or maybe you feel like you've lost your inspiration for your career, and you're going through this healing, restorative period. What's going on? Pile two. The Page of Cups, absolutely Pisces energy, and the Temperance card, healing, balance, yeah. Okay. So it seems like you've been ignoring what your body has been trying to tell you for the sake of keeping your career. However, you couldn't hold any longer. You gave in finally into the needs of your physical body first and foremost. With the Page of Cups, you are either trying to return to something from the past, or you're trying to return the glory to something from your past. Yeah, you've been very stubborn. You guys are not giving up on something here. I feel like something lost its spark, let's say. It's not as catchy anymore, or it's either a career that doesn't fulfill you, or it's no longer as fruitful, as lucrative as it used to be. However, you're not giving up on it because with the Princess of Cups, you're quite emotionally attached and you've invested a lot of time and energy into this. What opportunities are coming up? Princess of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles, Princess of Pentacles. You're doing everything in your power to bring life back to the situation. This is about, I'm not sure if it's a decision, but your career is sort of going into the direction, and it's either about what you love to do or what pays the bills and what pays you more. And for some of you, you might have to do what pays better, currently. Have the Eight of Wands underneath the Prince of Cups. You've been following your calling, I can see that. And you've been trusting slow and steady that this is what you're supposed to do, these are the seeds that you want to plant. Then, yeah, it feels like following your calling no longer works. Following what you believe to be your purpose no longer sustains you, it no longer inspires you. There is a lot of pride and ego that has generated in, and I guess it makes sense because the situation, your career situation, is something you've put a lot of time and energy into, a lot of effort into, and of course you're proud of it, but this pride and ego doesn't let you outgrow it when this is so obviously something meant to be outgrown. With the Princess of Cups, you see how she's sitting on the floor, surrounded by the moon, governed by the moon, and then you have underlying energies, Eight of Wands, aiming for the sun, aiming for the sky. She is on the floor, meaning she is in a lower vibration, and she is controlled or driven by the cyclical nature of things. You pick up the slack. You put in a lot of energy, maybe you get a client or two, or maybe you get a raise, and then things go back to how it was, and you lose the energy, you lose the inspiration. You re-motivate yourself and you lose the inspiration again. And with the Eight of Wands, this is clearly showing me you really have to allow yourself to outgrow this, to fly away. Although you will be brokenhearted, the Temperance offers healing. Your guardian angels are with you. They are going to help you heal through the process of letting go. But with the Nine of Pentacles, this peacock energy, there's a lot of pride in what you've accomplished so far. And it's difficult to let it go because I think a lot of you believe this still has potential to grow into something bigger, better, and different. But I feel that it doesn't. You have a page, you have a knight where things became steady and safe for you, and then things, boom, went down with the page again. And it's like you started from scratch, you really blossomed, but then whatever you created went into its initial scratchy DIY form, I guess. I'm not sure even how to explain it. It's like the quality of what you do reflects your inspiration and desire to do it so much. Even if you try to hide it, you really cannot. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. I heard something that really made my chest do a really weird thing that I felt inside my chest. Around my heart space, I feel it's almost like when your heart flutters. This is what I felt, because I heard this message. You prayed to the moon and you prayed to the past many times to tip the scales of destiny, and you tipped the scales many times, but spirit cannot go on and keep up the life force of something that has been expired. This is what I'm getting. And I'm getting that spirit has interfered many times with the situation to keep it, to sustain you, but spirit can no longer do that. I'm hearing you've avoided your destiny many times to stay here and stay committed. Oh, wow. Okay. Eight of Pentacles, Ace of Wands. Underneath the Prince of Pentacles. Now, Princess of Pentacles or the Page of Pentacles is fertile energy. You haven't lost your creativity. You haven't lost your... This doesn't even feel necessarily like creativity in the traditional sense. You haven't lost your ability to bring something to life, to bring something from the ground up, to build something from the ground up. You have not lost that ability. You have not lost your manifestation and magical ability. It's just that you can no longer apply your manifestation and magic in this outdated situation. And you might be thinking, why do my prayers not work anymore? Why is my magic so weak lately? It's because you've been pouring your energy in an expired situation, really. This is something specific for someone here. I'm really drawn to how light goes in these different directions from this wand. And I had a vision of neon lights or, you know, colored lights in this dark space. And I'm really thinking of a bar or a club and DJing for some reason. Some of you have a calling or a new path, an opportunity for a new path that is a lot more, it's wilder in its nature. It's much wilder in nature. It's a bit more extroverted. and I'm being shown that if you wanna succeed in your career, you can no longer stay in this introverted, friendly environment. It's funny, for some of you I see cooking, for others I see DJing. Yeah, of course these are very specific for someone out there, like one person or two people max. What career opportunities are ahead for Piles, you spirit? The Hermit. And the Judgment card. The Judgment is a resurrection card. It's a card of confronting your past and drawing your conclusions. You have to confront your past, you have to confront your introverted phase and draw your conclusions from it. What worked during that phase and what did not work? Did you feel more at peace? But did you feel lonelier? But did you feel more relaxed? But did you feel more lethargic also? Like this hermit phase, what were the pros and the cons? And what do you want to keep from the hermit phase going forward? And what do you want to ditch? That's the Judgment card. And the Judgment card is also a card of karma. So I definitely see this lunar, karmic, almost familial karma cycle. Your parents or your mother specifically could have gone through a similar thing with her career, with her dreams when she was younger. I'm hearing don't break your own heart. You've been very, very vulnerable, Biotsu. You see how her shoulder is naked? You've been very, very vulnerable, and you need that wild spirit reignited to feel like you're living again. And your career, what you do for a living, is a huge chunk of your life, and that's why I think it's so connected to your overall mental, emotional, even spiritual state. The Hierophant. Wow. Queen of Swords at the bottom. You have the Hierophant. Higher powers watching over you. With the Temperance card, I told you. A higher power is watching over this journey of yours. This Hierophant energy feels like a couple of things here. This could indicate that you've grown a lot spiritually. But at the same time, this commitment has restricted you a lot. It has isolated you a lot. Spirituality is first and foremost connection. Feeling connected either to a greater power, to other people, with connection is so essential. I feel like with the Hierophant, you have your ancestors watching over you. You have your guardian angel watching over you. This period of drought that maybe you've been through, this period of lacking inspiration or lacking energy, is a bit karmic, because I'm telling you, you tipped the scales of destiny. You forced the situation to continue longer than it should have had. And that's why you had to go through a period of not having all this energy. It's almost like paying off this karma. Okay, you got what you wanted, but now you have to pay for it. I'm really sensing this. And your ancestors are watching over you, trying to nudge you to exit this mindset that that's the way to go. To exit the mindset that a little bit of magic here, a little ritual there, and I'm gonna make it till my next salary, or I'm gonna make it till my next client. Spirit is saying, no, you should let go of this tendency. And with the Page of Pentacles, there is something about going back to who you were before you lost yourself to this drive to change your destiny, to control your destiny too much. Going back, not in a sense where you're devolving or you're, I guess, glowing down intellectually, mentally, spiritually. It's not about going back to become who you used to be, but going back to who you used to be before this Princess of Cups started to do what she started to do. Before she started to do the magic and the rituals, who you were and what were you fighting for back then? Because with that Judgment card, the past is being resurrected. And with the, I told you, Knight of Pentacles, then Page of Pentacles, you have this higher level and this bit lower level, but the Page of Pentacles brings something from the earth. It brings something fresh. The Knight of Pentacles carries something that's older, more mature. It's been done already. While the Page of Pentacles brings something straight from the earth. It feels like you need to go back to that metaphoric ground on which you were standing before you got into this karmic cycle here with the moon and with the magic, and to talk to that person that you used to be and to examine what was important to you back then, because there might be an opportunity to bring it back to life with a twist, with this Ace of Wands, to bring it back to life in a new light. And with the Eight of Pentacles, to continue work for a dream that you had abandoned because you bought into the visions and ideals of the Princess of Cups that were a little illusionary. Is there a planetary body, a constellation, an astrological aspect that affects you here? Mercury in the fifth house. The awareness of the power of love, many thoughts about or from investment, gambles, and other games. Oh, didn't I say? No, that was for pile one. I'm sorry. many words, your creations, your words become your creations, your spells became your creations, and with that Princess of Cups in the fifth house, look, I do not exclude sexual energy being used as a spell or a ritual for manifestation, but it's been depleted. And a lot of you might have felt as if you want to preserve that energy to yourselves, and that there is a reason why. And you've gone through some karmic things in order to return to your innocence and to appreciate it again and to start over. On a journey that's just more fun, okay? With Mercury in the fifth house, it's really time to do something that is more fun to you. To do things dramatically, artistically, to do things in a wilder way, in a more playful way. Communicate with the trust of a child, analyze fun romance and making art. Let your mind tell you how to do it dramatically. I think that Mercury is here, or Hermes is here, Thoth is here, is influencing you right now to get you on the right track with your spiritual beliefs and how they control your physical life and what you do with it. Because you need more balance when it comes to that. You've been a little bit out of balance when it comes to your spiritual beliefs and the wellness of your physical life. I'm hearing reclaiming your mind, because the fifth house is the house of the sun and number five is the Hierophant. Number five is change. Spirit is trying to help you reclaim your mind so you can get a clear idea of where you want to go with your careers. Until then, you won't have many opportunities until you decide to let go of trying to control your destiny. Destiny won't really present itself to you. Alright, Pile 2, I think that's all I have for you guys. I hope these messages are useful, I hope they help you, and I hope they resonate or give you clues and give you whatever it is that you needed. Thank you so much for watching this. I really appreciate you staying. I appreciate you being here on the channel. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to support my work. And also, you can find all of my information in the description box below. So, until next time, Pile 2, bye! Pile 3, for all of you who chose Petra or the postcard, let's see what your messages are. What do you need to know? What opportunities are coming up for you? What opportunities are coming up for Pile 3? In June or the next 3 months, career-wise. We have the Three of Cups, friendships. We have the Three of Pentacles. That's so cool. You might be going on a trip with your friends where you study together. You might be going to a school program with your friends. You might be going to work with your friends outside of your hometown, outside of your country. The Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, there's travel involved here, definitely. There's something also about enjoying your craft, enjoying your mastery, enjoying your skills. I feel some of you have already developed a level of skills and now you're just enjoying your skills. You're enjoying using your skills, furthering your skills, but you have a good basis and you're having fun with what you're doing. And with the Wheel of Fortune, there is an opportunity to travel, there is an opportunity to meet foreign people that will appreciate your work of art, your craft, your abilities, your skill sets, even if they are not in the artistic field, any other skill sets, still, you have the opportunity to present it to big people, important people with the Wheel of Fortune. Four of Swords. All right. And I think that in the summer you will be resting and rejuvenating because you're sure of what the future holds. With that Wheel of Fortune, there is something about being a master of your destiny, being sure of your destiny, knowing exactly where destiny is leading you, and feeling safe and secure, not having to overthink things. Seven of Wands. All right. There is slight competition here. Eight of Swords, Eight of Air. Okay. The Star. Listen. Oh, this is great. Overall, of course. And Nine of Air. Oh my God. Okay. So things are starting really well. The only issue here is you might feel like you have to stand out. You might participate in some competitive field or a competitive program. And although you know this is the big opportunity for you with the Wheel of Fortune, with the Star, it's a dream come true to participate in this program, in this competition. You're a little afraid. Am I going to win? Am I going to lose? I feel like a lot of you will gain recognition. If not winning the first place, you will gain recognition. But what I see, some of you might be comparing yourselves too much to your friends, and do not let this create nightmares and fears. You see, underneath, it's funny because the Four of Swords usually depicts a person that sleeps peacefully, while the Nine of Swords depicts someone who is awakened by a nightmare. Woken up by a nightmare. And it's a huge contrast here. So what the cards are showing me is that, first of all, you're keeping appearances. You may not be as successful as you want to be. In comparison to your friends or certain people that you're in the same field with them, and most likely you know them with the Three of Cups, and you're like, oh damn it, they're doing so well. Am I ever going to succeed? Am I ever going to be the lucky one? But I think you know very well that it's not luck, it's work with the Three of Pentacles, and you've been working hard enough. A spirit is saying to recognize your own accomplishments, to go back to a mentality that some of you might have had before, but you forgot about it. Go back to this mentality that you are your only competition, and the only comparison worth is the past version of you and the future version of you or the current version of you. Not your people, not your friends. Because I see that you might create blockages alone, by stressing yourself, by anxiety, while you're doing pretty good. I feel like you're doing good enough. It's just that you've met some perhaps very talented people that challenge your confidence. And with the Seven of Pentacles, work on that solar plexus chakra, do core exercises, eat lots of citruses, they really help. Eat lots of bananas, pineapple, any citrus fruits. Sweating really helps with the core, with the core and with the solar plexus chakra, therefore. But yeah, overall, I see that this summer, the next 4 months, you have the opportunity to travel, to be recognized, to put yourself out there in the public eye, to really showcase what you're capable of. Do not hold back on opportunities because your friends will be watching, or family will be watching, or you will be participating along with your talented friends. For example, there is this modeling, let's say, agency, and your friends that are also models will be going for it, and they're gorgeous, and you feel like, but if they go for it, why would they want me? I'm not gonna do it because I'm gonna embarrass myself. Do not think like that about any such similar situation. Participate, even if there are more talented people, apparently, in your own eyes. Participate. Do not hold back from opportunities because with the star underneath, I feel like for a lot of you in the next 4 months, you will be surprised by a lucky event, a lucky accomplishment, a lucky win, okay? A lot of you know where you want to go with your destiny, and you're very self-assured that you're gonna get there eventually. I just see that there are slight things rocking your boat that might persuade you away from your destiny and start to think, no, the only issue stopping you from achieving the success you want right now is really comparison. Don't do that, okay? Opposition, imbalance, a point of tension, and a power struggle. Comparison, comparison, comparison. Virgo, integrity, reverence, and service. In Venus, give and receive love, find value and see beauty. Listen, especially if the people you see as competition are people you love and these are your friends, but you can't help it. The best thing to overcome the sense of, oh my God, I should be competing with them, or we're gonna be put against each other, we're gonna be compared, etc. The best thing that you can do is to think of your friends, people that can help you. You help them with their work, you help them be the best version of themselves, and they help you be the best version of you. Of course, I understand not everyone is blessed with such friends, but here I see some genuine relationships that don't ruin them for yourself, obviously, by becoming paranoid about it and about the nature of said relationships. I'm gonna use this oracle, the tea leaves, to get more messages and clarification. Clarify the Venus, what blessings are coming to you? With Virgo and Venus, I feel that this, first of all, the blessing has to do with a job. So if you've been looking for a job, you will be granted a job. Also, the blessing has to do with a work life and yeah, work-life balance. Secret admirer. Oh, wow. Interesting because I told you something that you don't see will change your destiny. A destiny you didn't even dare to dream of will take place for you. Pile 3. For some of you, this is the exact type of a lover you've been waiting for and hoping for. It's happening for you. What blessings is Venus gifting you with? Pile 3. Archway. New opportunities, possibilities, and paths opening up. Go where you did not expect doors to open. Oh my god. Go where you did not expect doors to open and they will open up for you. The Seven of Earth. Dare, be brave, be bold. Use that solar plexus. Be courageous and put yourself out there with the Wheel of Fortune, and your dreams will come into fruition with the star. The stars will align for you when you put yourself on the path. Your fears are based on illusions, that much I can tell you. Clarify Virgo, please. Virgo season might be significant for you. Lobster, financial pinch. Okay, yeah, so it's possible that you are comparing two jobs with Virgo, two work fields. Which one is better? Which one should they choose? The Well, family wishes come true. You might be comparing two jobs, and one of them might be achieved through family, networking, and connections. Go for it, okay? With the Three of Cups here, this is Venus in Cancer. Don't reject out of pure pride. Don't reject help. Virgo is also the sign of help. How did I not think about this? Do not reject help when it comes your way. Just because you feel like, if I accept help, it means I'm not good enough on my own. No. Don't reject help. Don't reject the resources available to you. Spirit is saying that it's important to focus on gratitude. Because when you're grateful, you're open to receive. You must become open to receive. Give and receive love. I think that's another burden here, another illusion that blocks you from your destiny, is that I should do it on my own. No, you don't have to. You can receive help, you can do things through connections and networking and asking friends for help, okay? Spirit is really emphasizing to use the resources available to you. Use the resources that people are offering you, that they have. Don't be shy, okay? Do not be shy. For a lot of you, your dreams are coming true. Just don't let paranoia take over. And I feel like for a lot of you, very soon, after this dream come true, after you accept the help gifted to you, you will be able to relax and you will be able to rest and recharge. Even the Four of Swords astrologically corresponds to Jupiter in Libra, so an abundance of connections, an abundance of people. In order to succeed in your career right now, for the next 4 months, you need to open up your heart. You need to be more open in relationships. like the key to your career has to do with your relationships and the resources people are willing to offer to you. Blocks are lifted. Yes, yes, that's exactly it. Blockages are lifted. Previous obstacles came from fear and they are now lifted away. I'm hearing as long as you're doing things with a good, pure heart, you might be competing, you might be, you know, yeah, competing with your friends, you might be receiving help and still working very hard. Whatever you do to succeed, as long as you do it with a good heart, as long as you're able to cheer others and let others cheer you, blockages will be lifted from your way. There is something about embodying a light-hearted mindset and outlook on the situation that will help you tons to get your blessings with the Wheel of Fortune and with Venus and with the Star card. You had three really big cards on blessings, gifts. Accept your gifts, okay? One final card, hold on. One final piece of advice from Spirit for Pile 3 and their career opportunities. Sensitivity. Your sensitive feelings are your muse and inspiration for your creativity. Do not close off your heart. Pile 3, with you, it's not about grinding hard. With you, it's about softness and opening yourself up. And it's almost like the well of the universe, the well of fortune opens up to you once you soften your heart. For a lot of you, you might be entering the fields of beauty, wellness, makeup, health, cosmetics, organic clothing, organic recipes with Virgo here and Venus. A lot of you might be entering the field of healing people through art or healing people's relationships to their body, their relationship to a lifestyle. With a lot of you, you might become coaches for lifestyle because Venus in combination with Virgo is exactly that, the lifestyle. And it's almost like practice what you preach, Pile 3. You want to do this work, you gotta be an example of it. You want to help people manifest, be an example of someone who is open to fortune. And you have a lot of positive feminine energy. Yes, you have the opposition. Of course, you will always have someone, no matter the gender, who would be envious of you or you would envy them. But despite the opposition, I'm sensing a lot of positive feminine energy if you allow it. If you allow it, you will find very resourceful people at your side. Okay? And I'm getting that in your near future, these are divinely orchestrated people to be in your life. If it's going to make you feel better, these people are helping you because you helped them in your past lives. That's how it works. Blessings come to us because we've earned it. If not in this lifetime, in a past life. So you are totally deserving of what happens to you or what comes to you. There might be a slight financial pinch that will test you. Oops. You see how I accidentally flipped it? It's not gonna last long. It's really just a slight little test to see how you're going to react. But Spirit is saying practice what you preach. You have no blockages. Destiny is on your side. Okay, Pile 3, that's all I have for you. I hope I got to reassure you because that's really all you needed from this reading, it seems, based off the cards. I hope you resonated with the messages. Let me know in the comment section below. Like, share, and subscribe to support my work and the channel. And I hope to see you soon in my next reading. All of my information is in the description box below. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll talk to you soon.